aftermath of the 228 incident. The KMT desperately wanted the Taiwanese people to forget 228, forbidding any discussion on the subject. 228 has long been a prescribed taboo under the KMT government. Every year around February 28th, the KMT government becomes very nervous and steps up policing. Chen Fangming, historian and professor. I went to the University of Washington at Seattle to further my study. The library there had an excellent collection of Chinese books. I found a few volumes of official records on the 228 incident. I was deeply shocked. As a historian, how could such an important event in the history of Taiwan be so completely unknown to me? Secondly, as a Taiwanese intellectual, I was appalled that I was totally ignorant of this incident. I felt extremely ashamed of myself. Every year when the date of the National Day was approaching, a census investigator would come to check my census record. This was strange to me. It was like that every time. This means that you were on the KMT's domestic blacklist. Yes, it must be so. To break this political structure is no easy task. In February 1987, under the leadership of Zhen Nangrong, about 13 organizations gathered together and formed the 228 Peace Promotion Association. Zheng was the founder of the Era of Freedom Monthly, whose aim is to fight for 100% freedom of speech. Their goal is to build 228 memorials and force the KMT to be candid about all their wrongdoings and to reveal the truth surrounding the incident. They named February 28th Peace Day. They staged many demonstrations. The families of the victims, surviving witnesses, intellectuals, and people from all walks of life stood up together in joint unity. The government was then forced to address the matter. In 1990, the executive branch set up a 228 research unit. Taiwanese schools and experts were invited, and documents from both domestic and foreign sources were collected. In 1992, the 228 research report was published. In 1995, the 228 memorial was unveiled in Taipei's Peace Park, symbolizing the new beginning of our society and our nation. General education was promoted in Taiwan during the Japanese occupation. Many Taiwanese were thus able to receive a sound education. This gave Taiwan a sizable pool of well-educated people. Unfortunately, most of these elites were murdered during the 228 incident. As a result, this left Taiwan with a serious vacuum in leadership. The 228 Memorial Monument in the Peace Park was erected on February 28, 1995. On that day, President Lee Teng-hui, as the chairman of the KMT, apologized to the nation for the atrocities committed by his party in 1947. President Lee himself was once persecuted by the KMT. Tragedies of 228. History shall not be distorted. History shall not be fabricated. History shall not be forgotten. Grievances can be consoled. Harmony can be nurtured.